First Kings chapter 19. And I'm going to read a couple of verses. Let me read verse 9. And he came thither unto a cave and lodged there. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him. And he said unto him, what dost thou hear, Elijah? And he said, I have been very jealousy for the Lord God of hosts, for the children of Israel have forsaken thy covenant, thrown down thine altars, and slain thy prophets, and the sword. And I only, I am left, and they seek my life to take it away. And he said, go forth and stand upon the mount before the Lord. And behold, the Lord passed by, and a great and strong wind rent the mountains and brake in pieces the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind, and after the wind an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake, and after the earthquake a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire, and the fire, and after the fire a still small voice. And it was so when Elijah heard it that he wrapped his face in his mantle and went out and stood in the entering in the in of the cave. And behold, there came a voice unto him and said, what dost thou hear, Elijah? Father, we want to appreciate the authority in the word. We are praying today that God, you may minister to us, you may help us, my Father. We are weak vessels, O Redeemer King. We lean upon your grace, we lean upon your power. Mighty Father, we are praying that you're going to give us the voice to speak unto your people, my Redeemer Lord. We appreciate the grace, the presence that we can feel in this place. And we want to say thank you because we know your word is a sword and it's going to go forth, my God, to do the purposes and the assignment that God, it has been ordained to do. We thank you and we worship you. May your name be exalted forever. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. We need to realize in 1 Kings chapter 19, verses 19, we must know that this is a story of the encounter of the man of God and a wicked queen called Jezebel. We must realize that Elijah was called at such a time to counter the kingdom of Ahab and the kingdom of Jezebel. Let me subject to this congregation that whenever there is a wicked person being raised, the Lord must anoint an apostle, the Lord will anoint a pastor, the Lord will anoint an evangelist to counter the anointing of the wicked. Hallelujah. We want to say thank you to Jesus for allowing Pastor Thuku to come in this place, because we know you've come here with a cause. There was a wicked ruler in this place, there was a principality in this place, but the Lord has anointed a servant of God to counter a dark anointed person in this place. Hallelujah. Because with every person that is wicked, there is an opposite of it. There is an anointed man of God. With every Pharaoh I want to subject, there is a Moses. Hallelujah. With every Haman I want to subject to us, there is a Mordecai. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We must know that Elijah was a man of God. He was a man who was anointed as a prophet. There is no prophet among all prophets that has risen like this man called Elijah. Hallelujah. He was a great prophet who left a footprint in the history of Israel. He was a great prophet who has been known among eras and dispensation of prophets. He was a mighty prophet. We must know that God raised him to counter a wicked king, King Ahab. We must know that he was raised to counter
the worship of Baal, we must know that he was raised to counter the powers of darkness in the land of Israel. We must know that he was raised to counter the power of the wicked woman called Jezebel. We must know that he was raised and he did not leave a footprint in his generation alone. But we must know, even in the New Testament, he has been mentioned 30 times. There is no any other prophet who has been mentioned many times like Elijah. I know that Elisha had a double portion of what Elijah had, but I want to submit to you today, even if he had double portion, we must realize Elijah was much anointed and he had to be mentioned in the New Testament. If you doubt what I'm saying, in the Mount of Transfiguration, it was not Elisha who was seen, but the Bible says Moses and Elijah were seen in the Mount of Transfiguration. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The anointing that was upon Elijah was the same anointing that was upon Elisha. We must realize this man was great. He was able to call fire from heaven. He was able to call on the name of the Lord. And God was able to bring down fire. And the fire fell and consumed the burnt offering and the wood and the stone and the dust and the water that was in the trench. We must realize this is the man who was fed miraculous with ravens. We must know he was not fed only in the morning, but he was fed in the morning and in the evening. We must know he was fed of a delicious meal. He was fed with meat. He was fed with meal. He was fed with the banquet from the king's table. We must realize this is the man that God allowed to go to the widow of Zarephath, and he was able to release a prophetic word. And we know from the scriptures that when he was with the woman of Zarephath, the flood did not waste. We must realize the cruse of oil was not finished because of the grace and the anointing that was upon this man. But this morning I want to surprise you that this man, with all the accolade that I've mentioned, this man with all the anointing that I've mentioned, this man with all the great name I have mentioned about him, this man with the great assignment and appointment that he had, he was intimidated by a wicked woman after the contest of Mount Carmel. We must realize it is Elijah who flee from Jezebel. It was supposed to be vice versa, but we are surprised that the man Elijah, the man of God, the man who had just called fire down, is now running away from this queen Jezebel. It is not supposed to be that way. It was supposed to be vice versa. Hallelujah. I want to say that the same spirit that was operating in Jezebel, it is operating in the last days. There are many men of God who are running away. There are many pastors who are running away. There are many ministers of the gospel who are running away. There are many apostles and prophets. Even as we are speaking today, they are running away from this spirit of Jezebel. The spirit of Jezebel is working mightily in our days. The spirit of Jezebel is fighting churches. The spirit of Jezebel is fighting praise and worship teams. The spirit of Jezebel is fighting anointed men of God. But we have come today in a common agreement, and we want to denounce that the spirit of Jezebel will not operate in our days. The Lord is raising a young people. The race is raising old men and women that are anointed for this season, and we must put Jezebel to flee. Hallelujah. We must subdue the works of Jezebel. We must put Jezebel in his place. Hallelujah. It is not our place to run into caves, because the Bible records that when Elijah ran, he went and sat under a juniper tree. And when he was under the juniper tree, the Lord sent an angel, and the angel fed him with bread and water. And after a few days, he told him, the journey is so far. May you eat more. And when he ate, he went and hid himself in a cave. Hallelujah. We are not among those who shall hide in the cave. I have come today to announce and to say we are not running to the cave anymore. We want to tell the enemy we know our place. Our place is a place of victory. We want to tell the devil we know our place. Our place is a place of triumph. Hallelujah. We cannot fled when the Lord has done all things. We know Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. He came and died on the cross. Hallelujah. And he has delivered us from the power of hell. He has delivered us from the bondages of hell. He has taken away from us from the prison of darkness. Cave is not our place. Cave is a place where the devil wants you to be. Cave is a place where the devil wants the church to be. A cave is a place where the enemy wants me and you to be. But we refuse this morning that we shall not rot in the cave. We refuse this morning that we shall not perish in the cave. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have come today this morning, and we have come to proclaim there is power in the name. We have come to proclaim that we will not sit in the cave. We have come to proclaim that we shall not hide as the church of the living God. It is time the church of the living God to arise in power. It is the time the church of the living God to come to his position. It is time the church of the living God to stand on the platform of the nation and to declare among presidents and proclaim above parliament and say, we are the one who reign. We are the one who have heard from the Lord. We are the one who know what the Lord wants us to do. Hallelujah. If you are among the church, I want to allow you to celebrate. I want to call upon you to clap unto Jesus, because it's the author, is the finisher of our faith. Hallelujah. I just want to tell you, we have a mighty God. We are not among those who shall subdue. We are not among those who shall surrender. We are not among those who shall run in the cave. Yes, Elijah ran because of Jezebel, but God has anointed a generation in our day that shall not go into the cave. Cave is not your place, my brother. Cave is not your place, my sister. There is a better place. We are positioned in Jesus Christ. The Bible says that we are hidden with Jesus Christ in the heavenlies, and that is our position. We want to tell the devil this morning that the Lord has anointed young people. The Lord has anointed people for this cause. The Lord said in the book of Esther, we are in the kingdom at such a time as this for a purpose. I just want to announce, the church in Kenya, the church in Nairobi, it is in the kingdom at such a time for a cause, for a purpose, for a work, for an assignment. Yes. Hallelujah. And so there are many believers that are running from Jezebel. I want to tell you, the spirit of Jezebel has been operational from the book of 1 Kings, even to the book that we of Revelation. This woman was so wicked. This woman was so fiery and horrible. This woman was the one who drove the man of God into a cave. We don't know the name of the cave. But this morning, allow me to say, there are people that have been put in caves of shame. There are people who have been put in caves of pain. There are people who have been put in caves of pain and bitterness. There are people who have been put in caves of harsh experiences. There are people who have been put in caves of wrong relationships. There are people who have been put in caves of past experiences. There are ministers who are ministering, but they are no longer ministering because they are in caves, wounded in those caves. There are many people who are supposed to be standing at the pulpit this morning, but the enemy has ensured they are in a cave somewhere. That's why we don't see impact in the church. That's why we don't see impact of the church in Kenya. That's why we don't see the impact of the people of God in our workplaces. That's why we don't see the impact of the people of God in our neighborhood. That's why we don't see the impact of the men of God all over the world. But this morning, I have come to challenge us. I have come to tell us, we will not allow our talent to rot in the grave. We will not allow gifts to rot in the cave. We will not allow the anointing to rot in the caves. We will not allow the voice of authority to rot in the cave. The Lord has sent me with an assignment to tell somebody, we are not a part of the cave culture. We are not a part of the cave mentality. We are not a part of the cave environment. Oh, hallelujah. We will not remain stagnant. We will not hide anymore. But Lord is raising a soldier. The Lord is raising an army in these last days. We want to tell the devil, come on. We are here on a mission. We are coming to destroy the works of your kingdom. That's why the Bible says, for this reason was the Son of God revealed, to destroy the works of the enemy. Hallelujah. We have not come to amend the works of Satan. We have not come to decorate the work of Satan. But we have come with a cause. The Bible says the one that is in us is greater than the one that is in the world. We tell you, Mr. Devil, we tell your mother-in-law, Mr. Devil, we want to tell you that we are coming with the power. The anointing is upon us. In the day of Pentecost, the Bible says they were together in one place, and suddenly a sound from heaven coming down as a mighty rushing wind was heard, and all that were in that house, cloven tongues of fire appeared on their head. And the Bible says they were all filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. There is where the church was born. I just want to say, the church was not born in Antioch. The church was not born in Rome. There are some people who say the church was born in Rome, but I have come to neglect and say the church of the living God was born in Jerusalem with fire. And if the church was born with fire, we need to walk with fire. It is not time for Christians to walk in a calm way. It is not time for Christians to seek public relationships. It is not time for Christians to look wonderful. It is time for Christians to be radical. There are souls which are rotting in hell. There are souls which are in fire. There are souls which are perishing. There are souls in the hand of the enemy. But God shall rise a kingdom of soldiers, and we are going forth in the power of the Holy Ghost to subject every kingdom of darkness. Amen. Let us clap unto Jesus Christ. And so, there are many people in caves. Even as I speak right now, there are people who are serving God powerfully, but they are no longer serving God powerfully because the enemy has ensured them to be on the run. And right now they are hidden in caves somewhere. There are people that who are used of God with great anointing. They sang, and people all over the world were able to be touched with anointed voices in their song. But they are no longer doing so because the enemy has destroyed their testimony, and he has made sure that they are in the cave. There are men of God who are so anointed, they could intercede for the souls which are lost. They could pray for the souls which are lost. But the enemy has ensured that he has placed them in the cave. There are people that used to evangelize, and they could not finish a week without evangelizing. They could evangelize in the television. They could evangelize in the matatu. But they are no longer doing so because the enemy has ensured that we are in the cave. There are people that the enemy has put them in a wrong relationship. They have polluted their soul. They have polluted their mind. They have corrupted their beauty. And they are no longer usable for the kings. Because the enemy has ensured he must put them in the cave. There are people that wanted to serve God with zeal, but the enemy has allowed wounds in their soul, wounds in their spirit, bitterness and anger, and he has caused them to be in the cave. There are people who were used of God to release prophetic word, and the Lord was able to accompany the word that they spoke, and God was able to manifest whatever they spoke as prophetic utterance. But these days they are no longer prophesying because the enemy has caused them to run like Elijah. because of the spirit of Jezebel. I want to tell you, the spirit of Jezebel, it is under an assignment of Lucifer. The spirit of Jezebel, it is sent to corrupt, to destroy, and to make the church become really irrelevant. The spirit of Jezebel will make the church have music system. It will make the church have a good speakers. It will make the church have good music. It will make the choir of the church be known all over. But it will ensure that that church does not go beyond the cave. Hallelujah. I want to subject to us today. We are rising today because we know our family members, they have been put by the spirit of Jezebel in the cave and they are not born again. We know very well that the voices of the men of God, which was reaching all over the world, it is no longer going all over the world because Jezebel has silenced the enemy. Silence the church. We know we used to proclaim the blood of Jesus. We no longer hear the songs of the blood of Jesus in our churches these days because the enemy has made sure that the church is in the cave and they are no longer pronouncing there is power in the blood. Hallelujah. I have come to announce today we are coming out of the grave and we shall pronounce there is power in the blood. There is power in the blood. I want to tell the devil even this morning in this service, there is power in the blood. Hallelujah. If you are sick this morning, I want to remind you there is power in the blood. If there is anything that is disturbing you this morning, I want to tell you there is power in the blood. If there is anything that is disturbing you, I want to tell you there is power in the blood. Hallelujah. When you read the book of Hebrews chapter 12, 24, the Bible says that the blood of Abel does not speak better things, but there is a blood that is the blood of Jesus Christ. It speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Don't stay with the anointing in the cave. Come out of the cave. Don't stay with the anointing to sing in the cave. Come out from the cave. Don't sit with the anointing to preach in the cave. Come out from the cave. Don't sit with the anointing of worship in the cave. Come out of the cave. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. And the Bible says, Elisha was supposed to mentor some people, but now he was in the cave. There are people who need to be mentored by you. What are you doing in the cave of Jezebel? Come out from the cave of Jezebel. There is a Timothy for you to mentor. There is a John for you to mentor. Come out of the cave. There is an assignment. There is Elisha who needs a double portion in the mighty name of Jesus. There is a Joe who needs to be anointed because he has been assigned to kill Jezebel. And you know very well, Joe is the one who destroyed Jezebel. There is nobody with the anointing, but Joe, who was anointed because of Elijah's anointing, was able to destroy Jezebel. Come out from the cave. There is enough wealth. There is enough riches. We cannot sit in the place of poverty. The church of the living God is supposed to be a wealthy church. The church of the living God is supposed to be a rich church. Come out from the cave. The devil is a liar. He tells us that we need not to have wealth and riches. But I know riches and wealth belong to God. We must come out from the cave because riches belong to us. Hallelujah. Oh, there is work for us to labor. The Bible says laborers are few, but we must come from the cave. Praise the Lord. I have come today to announce with the unction of the Holy Ghost, we are no longer going to be bound in prisons of the cave of Jezebel. We are no longer going to sit comfortable in the cave of Jezebel, but we feel an unction. We feel a call in these last days. We feel a call in these last days, and we have been ordained and put in places of authority, and we must do the assignment of the living God. If you believe the church is on the victory side, can you shout hallelujah? Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Give the Lord a better shout. Oh, hallelujah. You can shout as a victor. You can shout as a victor. You can shout as a victor. Oh, Oh, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to tell you this morning, oh, glory to God. Go and take your suit. Go and take your good dress and say, Satan, I have been in the cave for a longer time. You put me in the cave for a longer time, but I have come to commission somebody. Now take your Bible and come out from the cave and say, there is a cause. I was born with a purpose. I was born with a cause. I will not perish without accomplishing my purpose. My purpose must come to a fulfillment. Oh, hallelujah. I want to arise a young person who is in campus. Arise in the campus. When every person is worshiping idols, when every person is worshiping gods in campuses, you can arise with the authority, with the anointing, and come out from the cave. Yes. Hallelujah. The church of God will not be in the cave anymore. We know that the Lord has a cause for us. Hallelujah. I finished by telling us, there was one day a man whom Jesus loved. He was known as Lazarus. And the enemy made sure that Lazarus was in the cave. And he was there for 4 days. And he began stinking in the cave. But you must know biologically, when somebody is stinking in the cave, this person, there are processes, biological processes, which have already taken place. The maggot, the housefly, has already laid eggs in the nose. You must realize, right now, when the person is stinking in the grave, the egg has grown into a maggot, and the maggot is feeding on the body, and the body is now in the process of decomposing. But it didn't matter how many days this man was in the cave. It didn't matter how many days he was in that place. When the Lord of glory came to this grave site, there was a difference. It did not matter the Pharisees who were in that place. But when Jesus came, the Bible says, it did not matter. He was stinking. It did not matter that he was in the cave for 4 days. But the Bible says, when he came, he said, come forth. And I want to tell you what took place. That millipede that had eaten the body of Lazarus had to vomit the body of Lazarus. I want to tell you that spider that had eaten the body of Lazarus, it did not matter if the body of Lazarus was in the belly of the spider, but the word of Jesus, which said, come forth, was so powerful, was so miraculous. The millipede, the spider, had to vomit the body of Lazarus. Oh, hallelujah. I just want to tell this church, there are some things that the Lord is commissioning. Demons of hell are vomiting something that belongs to you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. There is something that the enemy has taken of you. I have rise today to tell you, the devil must vomit. Oh, hallelujah. Satan is a liar. He cannot bind you anymore. He cannot bind you with diseases. If you are in this service with a disease, under the unction and the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I want to subject that malaria. I want to subject that disease of the stomach. I want to subject any virus in the blood, any bacteria in the blood right now, in the mighty name of Jesus. Satan is a liar. By his stripes, we are healed. Oh, hallelujah. We serve a powerful God. I want to subject, we should not walk like chicken. We should not walk like people who are failures. We should not walk as if we don't have a purpose. The Lord has already said, come forth. Hallelujah. And this morning you can arise on your feet, because the Lord has already come to the gravesite. The Lord has already come with the word. It did not matter if the Pharisees had spoken negative words. The Pharisees had said, he will not rise up again. But the coming of Jesus, it put a full stop to the people who were at the graveside, who were mourning and weeping because of Lazarus. Oh, glory to God. We must come out of our caves, because the Lord Almighty has come, because the Lord of glory has appeared, because the Lord of glory wants to commission us again. Oh, hallelujah. And so the Bible says that the voice came to Elijah when he was in the cave, and the voice said, come forth. What are you doing in this place? I have come to pose the same question. What are you doing in the cave? What are you doing in that place? There is a big cause for you. Hallelujah. It is not time for us to sit in our offices and gossip. There are people who are perishing. It is not time for us to sit and make gossip with our friends. There is an assignment for us to do. That place is a place of cave. It is not time for us to sit and feel comfortable. There are people who are bound in drugs. There are people who are bound in alcoholism. There are people who are bound in immorality. There are prostitutes in our city. Arise, the Church of Kenya. We must reach forth with the power of the Holy Ghost. We must pray. We must intercede. Where are people who can intercede for 21 days? Where are people who can intercede for 7 days? Where are people who can intercede for 40 days for a soul? I want to be challenged this morning. I am coming out of this meeting fired up again to go and pray for 40 days, to go and pray for 21 days, to go and pray for 7 days, to go and pray for 3 days for a soul that is perishing. We will not allow the devil to set his kingdom in Nairobi. We will not allow the devil to set his kingdom in Kisumu. We will not allow the devil to put his kingdom in Nyeri. We will not allow the devil to put his kingdom in Kirinyaga. We will not allow the devil to put his kingdom in Karatina. We refuse, and we are arising today. We want to tell the devil, you are in trouble. We have come with the power of Elijah. We have come with the power of Elijah. We have come with the power of Moses. The Red Sea must open in the name of Jesus. Moses told them, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I want to tell any person in this room, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us we are more than conquerors. You must understand the word more is different from much. We are more than conquerors. We are not just conquerors. We are more than conquerors. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. I don't know if there's somebody today in this place who wants to come out of the cave. There is a soul that is perishing, and we must go forth and reach that soul. Hallelujah. The Lord told Jehoshaphat, this battle does not belong to you. I want to pronounce to the church in Kenya, the battle does not belong to us. It doesn't matter even if VAT has gone up to 8%, even if they want to put it to that 2%. I want to tell you, the church must prosper. The church will stand. The church will overcome. The church will come out of the cave. The church will continue doing miracles. We will continue speaking sight to the blind. We will continue speaking to the damp. We will continue opening the ears of the deaf. Hallelujah. Out of this meeting, somebody will pray for the sick and they are going to recover. Out of this meeting, somebody will pray for the blind and they are going to recover their sight. Out of this meeting, somebody shall preach and people shall be delivered. Satan is a liar. We have an army that the Lord is raising. We have an army the Lord is raising. The devil is a liar. Pastor Benson, I want to tell you, continue preaching. Continue speaking the word of God. Hallelujah. We are not just limited in Nairobi. We are not just limited in Kenya. But I want to tell us that we are in a season, that we are going above. We are going to the nation. There are people who are perishing in Uganda. There are people in Zimbabwe. There are people in South Africa. There are people in India. There are people in Asia. We must reach them. Hallelujah. People are fearing to tell the people, the cross is the solution. The cross is the solution. Uh-huh. Yes, we are not just people. Iduku is an engineer, but he's preaching the cross. Hallelujah. In this room, there are people getting good money, six figure, but they are still preaching the gospel. They are still preaching the cross. You don't preach another gospel. We are not here to appease people. The cross is the power. The Bible says, when you read the book of Corinthians, it says that the preaching of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. That's why the Apostle Paul said in the book of Romans chapter 1 verse 16, I am not ashamed of the gospel of God. It is the power of God unto salvation. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. So we want to conclude by saying, we are the church and we will not put our position in the cave. I've just come to tell and to challenge this church, the nation of Kenya. We have stayed in the cave for a long time. We have hidden for a long time. Even when you are seated in our matatu, you cannot share the gospel with the person that is seated opposite to you, because we are ashamed. We are ashamed of who we are. We should not be ashamed of our identity. We should not be ashamed of the name. Oh, hallelujah. In fact, these days, many musicians, when they are giving out record and albums, I have realized many albums, they are lacking the name Jesus, because people are ashamed of the name of Jesus. But I've come to give you a revelation. This Jesus is the mighty God. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, that unto us a son is born, unto us a child is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be the Prince of Peace, his name shall be the Wonderful Counselor, his name shall be the Everlasting Father. The Son is the Everlasting Father. His name shall be, I want to put it clearly, the Almighty God. According to Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6, he says, I will give you a sign, and a son will be born, and this son shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. We are not ashamed of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. People can easily say God, praise God, but they cannot say praise Jesus, because we are fearing this name. But this is the name that saved us. There is nobody who was saved without this name. Whoever who shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that's why we need to brag because of this name. We know where this name took us from. We were in the pit. We were rotting. We were not having identity. We did not have a name. But this name has made us to be what we are. And that's why when I'm walking on the street, I'm ready to pronounce Jesus saves. Oh, yes. Let us be on our feet. Still